The next parable, talents. One received one, one received two, one received three, one received five. This guy used the talents and from two he got four. That guy used the talents, from four he got eight. This guy used it, from five he got ten. This guy says, I'm going to bury it. He didn't use it. What happened to them? Those who used the talents, they were saved. The talents were blessed and multiplied. Those who buried the talent, they lost it. Not only that they are not blessed, not multiplied, but they perished. How do you prepare for the second coming? You don't need to be a pastor. Whatever talent God gave you, use it for God's honor. And if you use it, it will be multiplied. If you don't lose it, and you lose salvation. Pretty simple. You follow me? Well, let me explain a little. There were many people, it says in the Bible, 5,000 men. In that time, they didn't count. Israel got out of Egypt, 600,000 men. They didn't count women, they didn't count children, they didn't count retirees. They counted only men for war, between 21 and 55. But the history says that 600,000 men for army got out of Egypt, plus children, plus women, plus retirees, all around 1.5, 1.6 million people. The same with Jesus' story. 5,000 men, plus wife, plus children, plus retirees, who knows, 15, 20,000 people in the crowd. Jesus is preaching, people are hungry. Many people had food, but they could have said, how could my food feed 20,000 or 15,000 people? So they didn't give it. One child didn't ask mathematical, logical questions. How could my two fish and five breads feed 15,000 people? He just gave it. Only his was blessed and multiplied. When you use your talents, God is going to multiply them so you could use them. And that's another key. How do you prepare for the second coming? You don't prepare cold, as she says, in idle expectation. That's what the Spirit of prophecy says. You don't prepare in... I'm waiting. You don't prepare in idle expectation. Use the talents that God gave you. If you are an engineer, whatever you do in your job, do it in a way that when people see you, they see Jesus in you. If you are a farmer, if you are whatever job, computer, engineer, or whatever, do your job in a way that you are a blessing for others, you are a light for others, you are salt for others. Care for people the way Jesus cares for people, because that's religion.